welcome back to another day of 31 Days of Horror. I'm your host, Stephen Bloodworth, filmmaker and indie film critic. Thank you so much for coming by. There's really no debate in saying that Wes Craven is one of the greatest of the horror genre. From The Hills Have Eyes, to The Last House on the Left, to the Nightmare on Elm Street series, etc., Wes Craven has made a staple of himself in the horror genre. He's made several different horror films, but when it comes to the most different, I think the icing on the cake has to go to Shocker. The film starts off with a news report showing the grisly murders of a serial killer known as Horace Pinker. Horace is a strange and psychotic TV repairman, and is seen always walking with a limp. John is a football player, and he develops some strange connection with himself and Pinker. John actually dreams that he can see his family being held hostage by Pinker. John can actually see his entire family being held hostage by Pinker, and when he wakes up, he realizes that Pinker has gone after his family and has killed them. John's stepfather is a lieutenant for the town's police department and insists on letting him help with trying to bring down Pinker. Surprisingly enough, John is able to take down Pinker, and he is sentenced to death by electrocution. But before he's executed, he performs a bizarre ritual with his television in his jail cell, pretty much connecting the cables to him and basically shocking him in some weird way that I can't even describe. Pinker is executed and is presumed dead, but John feels that Pinker is still out there somehow. Pinker is dead physically, but his spirit is able to live on throughout several different people he comes across. Horace takes possession of a police officer, a jogger, a little girl, a mother, and just about anybody he can come across. John is trying to put an end to Pinker once and for all, and even receives aid from his deceased girlfriend who comes back as a ghost. She explains to him that the necklace that he had given her when she was alive will weaken Pinker and hopefully bring him down. This is definitely one of Wes Craven's more lighthearted films, not being as serious as films like Last House on the Left or The Hills Have Eyes, but by far one of the most epic scenes in any 80s horror movie, and probably any horror movie to this day, is when John enters the television and tries to stop Pinker. Basically, they go through several different channels and television shows, and even gains attention from the people inside of the television. Shocker is one of those films that is best watched with a group of friends. Well, we're out of the 80s, and I know that the 90s doesn't have as much to offer as the 70s and the 80s, but I found a few good ones, so stay tuned.